Catholic child, which he is, for sure. I'm not saying he's not, but to try and see him as like a full, real human that's been brought up in this crazy realm that, you know, there's just so much violence and backstabbing and manipulation, and that he's kind of a product of that. So I wouldn't say, I mean, there are some funny moments, I suppose, but he finds things funny that maybe he shouldn't find funny. But, so in terms of the character development, maybe just trying to make him more whole, but I don't think he's fun when he's like murdering people.
Yeah. we all heard theories about what we think is going to happen at the end of Game of Thrones, so I've got to ask you, do you have any theories?
Well, yeah, I mean, I just got an email from the producers and they just told me every single plot line. I'll get it up for you in there. It's funny, I feel bad saying it, but I've never like kind of consistently watched the show, because when I was in the show, it's horribly awkward and cringeworthy watching yourself on screen. Like, if anyone has even heard their voice recorded, you're like, is that me? Does that sound like me? I'm not sounding like that. So that's like that experience time to build it. So I haven't really watched it since I left the show either. So I don't know. Something to do with dragons, something to do with, I don't know, magic, something with ice and fire. Yeah. I've heard a lot about it. Something about a throne.
Okay, speaking of
a game of thrones.
Who would you like to see take the throne game this season?
Oh, I was gonna say his mama.
I think it would be cool if like Daenerys,
yeah. Woo!
You know, if I mean, you know, Cersei. Cersei's on the throne now, but she's kind of lame. Kind of like, you want a strong woman up there to knock some sense into people, and I think Daenerys is the woman to do it.
Woo!
I don't think Cersei would like us talking about her like that. So, when you were coming up with your character, I read that you took inspiration from Commodus. In Gladiator, who's played by Joaquin Phoenix,
yes.
Is that something that you kind of came up with before going into the audition, or if the character was progressing?
To be honest, it was just something someone asked me in an interview. They said, did you have any, like, influences? And I didn't. I honestly didn't have any, but I thought that would be arrogant to say. So I just came up. I mean, so I just kind of made up that I was influenced by. Come on. Obviously, it's a really good performance and that kind of thing. So maybe subconsciously, I was influenced by it. Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
I did all this research.
I
was like, oh, Commons, that's a good role.
Yeah. Okay. I don't know. Yeah. No, but I mean, I feel like. There was no one specific character or portrayal, but definitely, you know, I watched so much TV and films growing up as a kid, read comic books and stories, so I feel like Joffrey is kind of an amalgamation of all of the kind of horrible bullies and egomaniacal kids that he grew up with. Yeah, not in real life, but fictional worlds.
I can't imagine what it's like being part of a show that is as popular as Game of Thrones. I mean, when did you know that it was getting really popular?
I'm not sure if there was a moment. Like, I'm trying to think. I'm not sure if there was a moment. I mean, it's still pretty surreal. I don't think I fully get. I mean, I'm still baffled that people want to come and get something signed by me or come and listen to me talk. So I think I'm still coming to grips with it. So maybe like on my deathbed, I'll kind of get an epiphany. That's such a big thing. But yeah, when you are able to kind of take yourself out of it and realize the vastness of the show, it's very humbling, and you feel very privileged to be part of it.
Well, we're going to do some questions in just a second. We have Miguel right there in the middle, so if you guys have some questions, get them ready.